guys, welcome to the PageFly video tutorial series. In today's video, you'll learn how to avoid theme conflict. Specifically, we'll be covering how to make a page look exactly the same in the PageFly editor as it does on the live view, how to make a section full width, and how to remove blank space on the top of a page. Firstly, what is theme conflict? In some cases, the theme style code of your Shopify theme can replace PageFly's code, which can lead to some issues on your page. PageFly only conflicts with some themes, such as Brooklyn, Debut, Narrative, or some customized themes, but not all themes. In this video, we're going to show you how to fix some issues that arise from theme conflict by giving you a demo on Shopify's Brooklyn theme. But remember, you can use the following methods for any theme that conflicts with PageFly. So, if you find some elements on your page different between the PageFly editor and on the live view, such as font styles, font sizes, buttons, colors, etc., it means that there is a conflict between PageFly and your theme. So to fix this, we head to the PageFly editor and toggle on theme styling, just here. Please note that when you turn on theme styling, the page in PageFly editor and on the live view will be the same. The old default styling has been overridden by theme styling. So now you can adjust headings, fonts, all that sort of thing. And when you're ready, can publish and then head on to live view to check that they're the same. So there we go. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to make a section full width. So maybe you've added a full section already and you've disabled the option for set fixed width in the general tab, but the section still doesn't look like how you want it to look on the live view. This is also because of the conflict between PageFly and your theme, because some themes do not support making a section full width. In this case, we need to add custom CSS code to fix the problem. So in the description of this video, you'll find three links to three separate CSS codes. You're going to have to try each of these out to see which one works for your theme. Our store is using Brooklyn theme, so this code works for us. I'm simply going to copy this code, head back to my PageFly page. I'm going to add custom code here and paste the code in here. Then we're going to save change and publish. And once it's published, we can head back to live view to see how it looks on our store. There we go. You can see the section is full width now. Okay, so in the final part of the video, I'm going to show you how to deal with blank space at the top of a page. Sometimes you may find a blank space in between your header and your first element, which is caused by theme conflict. So to fix this, we need to add another custom CSS code. Again, you'll find this code in the description of the video. So we're going to copy our code here, head back onto the editor, add custom code again, and we can add a new line and paste it in here. Okay, then we'll save change and publish. And then we will live view. And there you go, you can see the white space in between the header and the first element has been removed. Please note that this code only works for some Shopify free themes, such as Brooklyn, Debut, or Narrative. If it doesn't work for yours, then please contact us via the in-app live chat on PageFly and we'll help you out. Okay, so that's the end of the video. Hope you guys all now understand more about theme conflict. To learn more about PageFly, check out our other video tutorials or visit our help center. Thanks for watching. See you next time.